Lord, you are exalted over all.
Blessed name of your
Lord, God of Israel, our Father, from eternity to eternity.
Lord, you are exalted over all.
Yours, O Lord, are grandeur and power, majesty, splendor, and glory.
Lord, you are exalted over all.
Lord, you are exalted over all. Yours, O Lord, is the sovereignty. You are exalted as head over all. Riches and honor are from you.
Lord, you are exalted over all.
In your hand are power and might. It is yours to give grandeur and strength to all.
Lord, you are exalted over all. Alleluia.
He instructed them to take nothing for the journey but a walking stick. No food, no sack, no money in their belts. They were, however, to wear sandals, but not a second tunic. He said to them, wherever you enter a house, stay there until you leave from there. Whatever place does not welcome you or listen to you, leave there and shake the dust off your feet in testimony against them. So they went off and preached repentance. The 12 drove out many demons, and they anointed with oil many who were sick and cured them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We hear that line often in the Gospel, or we're reminded of it often, to shake the dust off your feet. Those who do not welcome you or accept you, those who are really not kind and loving, to just leave it behind, to shake the dust from your feet and to move on. Not to shake the dust from our feet means that we're holding on to something. And you know what that does, it eats away at our very soul. When we have sentiments in our heart and in our very being about what went wrong years ago or even yesterday. And not to bring it before the Lord and to shake that off from our feet and to move ahead. Let that dust settle. And the Lord says, in testimony against them. Because when that dust settles, it does affect them. Maybe to think twice. It affects us too. It's always both then, not either or. It's an understanding when things go not our way that we take another look and that we are humble enough to recognize our mistake and also to move on from someone who is really not kind, generous and loving and friendly and God-fearing, to shake the dust and to move on and to allow that dust to be a testimony against them so that they could experience what just happened. I have to think about this. Let me just take the time now to reflect. And that's not only for them, like I said, but for us as well. We've been in many of those situations where we have been humbled. And sometimes the first reaction is what? Anger, upsetment. But then we have to like just step aside, step back, and let everything settle. They say, let the dust settle. And then we move on and take from that what we really needed to understand and learn. Because all of life lessons give us a chance to reflect on what really matters most and what really is a priority or something that could let go. Sometimes we treat things that are so minor as a 10 when they're really a 2. We have to learn how to step back and relax and to really digest what just happened and learn from the experience. There's going to be times in the future, today or tomorrow or maybe next week or next month, that they may happen to you or to someone else. But let's not just react hastily. Let's just take the time to learn from life's lessons and never react. St. Therese always tells us never to react when we're super excited or super sad, to be even keeled. That's how we, the Spirit, can breathe in us and to make that right decision no matter what, under the guidance of the Spirit. Today also is the optional memorial of St. Blaise, Bishop and Martyr. And customary, the blessing of throats today is held throughout the church. And probably in most parishes like ours, it will be done again over the weekend so that everyone can enjoy the devotion. But again, it's a reminder. It's a reminder how God uses the physical world to enter into the life of the soul. That it just doesn't end with the physical reality, that it deepens the relationship of the soul. That's why even with the shaking of the dust and all that, it's something that happens to us in the physical realm, but it goes very deeper. That's why we need to take a step back to reflect, to understand, and to be humble enough to move back into the right direction. Because sometimes we can choke from the dust. And that's not always a bad thing, because you know why? We stop. We clear our throat. We clear our mind. It makes us stop. And we reflect what is going on internally, deep within the soul. As St. Blaise was a good bishop and a martyr for the faith, as you could tell by the vestment, he also really took care of that little boy, didn't he? That had that little fishbone stuck in his throat. And everybody was so happy and praised God for that gift of that miracle. May God always clear our throat so that we can speak his message with conviction and not compromise. And that we can learn in humility when something goes wrong, and that we don't react hastily or in terrible anger, but that we reflect how could it benefit my soul. May God continue to bless us as we continue this Holy Mass. And remember this holy bishop, this martyr of faith, St. Blaise. After reflecting on God's holy word, let us now place these petitions before the Lord with confidence and trust.
For church leaders, may they be filled with divine wisdom in their service to the faithful, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our world, may Christ's peace touch the hearts of leaders and influencers and lead them to harmony. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the chronically ill, may God's love be a source of comfort and healing in their time. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here, may the Lord bless us and keep us free from all evil. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, may they soon see God face to face. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, Jenny Klingler, Charles Jones, Suzanne DeSantis, and all those on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Michelle Dusa, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also pray for the spiritual and temporal needs of St. Mary's Parish, so that all of us may further the mission of Jesus like St. Blaise did. Let us pray to the Lord. Let us also pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, especially for members of our own parish family. Let us pray to the Lord. Good and gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they're in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me, says the Lord.
you give me the holy bread.